The DEXIS IS ScanFlow using the Occlusion Check and Undercut Check tools recorded class. This recorded class is designed for clinical team members. It provides instruction on using the Occlusion Check and Undercut Check tools in the IS ScanFlow software. By the end of the session, you should be able to use the tool to measure the distances between opposing arches. In this session, we will explore the Occlusion Check and the Undercut Check tools in the DEXIS IS ScanFlow software. Let's get started with the Occlusion Check tool. You can use the Occlusion Check tool when you are in the scan mode or the check mode by selecting this button here. Once you engage this option while in the scan mode, the software will perform a quick refinement to provide you with a 2D rendering. When the software finishes the refinement, this window will appear here presenting the same byte information. With the Occlusion Check tool engaged, we can place the crosshair on the top of a prep. This creates a 2D slice on the 3D arch. At this point, we can use the grid pattern or the measurement option by left-clicking from one surface to another. If there's a particular position that you want to measure, you can grab the 2D slice using this line here with the spheres on the end to adjust the 2D slice. You can rotate it around to the position needed and check from the mesial to distal contact. Then you can take a snapshot by selecting this button here. This is a great communication tool that will automatically send the data over to the lab through IS Connect. The JPEG will also be saved in the patient's record so that you can retrieve it later if needed. This functionality works in the same way whether you are in the scanning mode or check mode. You can use the grid pattern to help you with your measurement. Here, we have a 2.4 millimeter measurement. As you can see, these squares represent millimeters. Let's now make another measurement. If the measurement is overlapping another, you can remove it by selecting Restore. I will now measure a different area that I can read better and take a screenshot if needed. You can restore and reset all of it using the Restore and Reset buttons and roll the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. To reposition the slice in the viewing area, right-click and drag. To start measuring, click the left button. I will now reset everything and click the Occlusion option to disengage it. Next, I will proceed to the check mode. Once the refinement is completed, we can see that the Occlusion Check option is always available. No matter if you are in scan or check step, the Occlusion Check tool functions the same way. Let's now explore the Undercut Check tool, which is only available during the check step. First, we need to select an arch. I will select the lower arch since this is where our prep is. Then we need to position the arch in the direction of the path of insertion that we want to have. We can zoom in or zoom out, whatever is more convenient for us. Then, we can select the Undercut Check tool and engage a selection by left button clicking and dragging out to include the prep tooth. The software checks for intercuts based on our selected path of insertion. We can use this option if we discover that the space is not enough or want to change it because of the measurement. At the end, we can disengage that option or take a snapshot if I want. This concludes the DEXIS IS ScanFlow using the Occlusion Check and Undercut Check tools recorded class.